final act.
Yeah. So we're here with Dirk. Can you please show your card? Thank you very much. And you've been having strong feelings about what's going on here in the conference. Tell us about that.
That's very true. First of all, my name is Dirk Jansen. I'm both the youth representative of the Netherlands to the United Nations, as well as working for the International Water Week in Amsterdam. And that's why I'm here. And if you walk around here, interesting things happen, especially here, actually, where so many people come with their stories about their communities or about their beliefs or motivation to work on water issues. And with this medium, thousands of people can see and reread and re-listen their stories. But if you go to the conference halls and if you listen to the leaders, the people that have the power, and sometimes also the academia that are the leading figures in these discussions in the conference halls, you hear so many different stories. What I'm passionate about, what I find important, is the question: how come we're already working for tens of years on these issues, and there's still such a big problem, and there are problems of hundreds of millions of people lacking safe water and sanitation, the things that where it's truly about, are still not solved. And I think it's mainly an issue about leadership. People say, yes, there's a lack of political leadership. What I want to do is ask that question: why is there a lack of political leadership? And how can we, even though not leaders in business or in government, try to change that leadership a bit? What I think is that a good solution, a solution that leaders should push for, is and a solution that we can demand, is not only a solution based on science and on theories, hopefully that reflect reality, but also solutions that are really supported by all stakeholders. And too much in the conference rooms, in the corridors where the leaders are walking and talking, these stories are not heard. So that the support for their solutions is missing, or the solutions are just the wrong ones because they don't work.
So you're saying we have to help bridge the communication between the people that's working in the communities to the leaders?
Yes, and change that leadership a bit. You can do it in different ways. We have to have that interaction to change the current leaders, but that's a bit difficult because they're often already all in the same way. So what I think two interesting thoughts could be is that we massively have to increase investment in future leaders, young leaders, that they not only have the technical solutions, but also really value where it's about. Know the life stories of this young girl in India not having safe drinking water. And valuing that, having the emotional
connection,
click with it. Why? Because then you have the passion and drive to really push it through and say, I don't mind, I don't care about you not wanting to do it. I want to see the implementation. I'm going to go for it.
Yeah.
That's one. And two, maybe a small suggestion, is that there's so many people in the water sector being so passionate about these water issues. Don't let the politicians or the business leaders get away with it. Go become a leader yourself, so that you, as a conscious person about water issues, can push these solutions through so it can really work on solutions for these hundreds of millions of people where it's truly about, and that still needs water.
Like a perfect idea. Thank you very much.
Thank you.